Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
One. Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen. It's Wednesday, the 1st of May, 2013, and I got some updates for you. Being the 1st of May, hey, it's payday. That's always a good thing. But let me give you a recommendation on what not to overly spend your money on. How about alcohol? Ignorant oil has caused us some more problems again. I got some uncool things to talk about here. Over the weekend, we picked up our 12th DUI of the year. And unfortunately, yesterday, we picked up our 13th DUI of the year. In both cases, the individuals blew over a .08 BAC, which means they were well over twice the legal limit. This is not good. This is unsat. Again, if you get behind the wheel of a car, make sure you've not had any adult beverages before you do so. There's an old aviation saying, so many hours between bottle to throttle, you probably should do the same thing, so many hours between bottle before you get behind the wheel of a car, just to make sure you're good. Additionally, we had a drunken disorderly over the weekend in which the individual had to try really hard to get up to this BAC. It was a .23, not a .023, a .23. That person was pickled. So we get all that money in your pocket here today from your payday. Think about using it on other things besides buying too much alcohol for yourself. You might have noticed down by Kearney Gate, that's the main gate, the sidewalk that's the closest to it is closed. That's not going to reopen. It's going to be closed permanently. We're going to be removing the lines. We had put in another sidewalk just a little bit closer from there. That's a lighted sidewalk. The reason that crosswalk has to go away is because it is located between the pop-up bollards and also another barricade. You're not allowed to have a crosswalk between those things. So that crosswalk is going to be going away, and right now it's not going to be used. We've got signs posted there, so that's the reason the crosswalk has been closed. This week, the rest of the week, you still got to finish off is mandatory school re-registration for the school year for 2013-2014. Re-registrations can be done over at the Kinnick High School Forum for the schools here on the main installation. While on the topic of schools, this coming school year will be the last year for Bird Elementary up in Nagishi. Bird Elementary will not be opening for the 2014-2015 school year. That's the same year that the new Ikego Elementary is going to open, and we have a very low enrollment up at Nagishi. We don't expect it to go up anything significantly, so the students that will be at Nagishi living up there, their elementary school, will get bused over to Ikego starting the following school year. Not this coming one, but the year after that. I hope a lot of people got the chance to go over to Fleet Theater the last 2 days and take a look at Scream. Scream is a sailor's challenge in reality and education against myth. It is sailors putting on a presentation. The play and the presentations and the skits that they do are all usually based off of, again, alcohol and sexual assaults. Reminder, sexual assaults continue to be a problem. It is still a high ticket item with the CNO. We have a working group going on right now and a pilot program happening here at Yokosuka. Focus on that topic, on that problem all by itself. So I want you to remember, good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. And one of the reasons I say that all the time is it still happens too much blue on blue, and that's another thing we need to knock off. As 6 May through 14 June, Benny Decker Theater is going to be closed. They're going to be replacing the flooring on the stage. Fleet Theater will be open during that whole time frame. And then once Benny Decker is done, Fleet's going to get closed for the same type of repair job. So the theaters are going to be doing some upkeep and some maintenance there. We still have the Chief of Naval Operations scheduled to be here on the 10th of May. He plans on holding an all-hands call. We're going to lock in the time. It was originally at 0800. It may slide a little bit to the right, so we'll get that word out to you. But you will have the opportunity to come out and see and talk to the CNO if you desire. Today starts the 2013 Overseas Housing Allowance Utility and Maintenance Survey. This applies to all service members who reside in off-base housing and have leases under the OHA program. This is your chance to give input, and it can be money in your pocket. It can affect the rates that you're going to get for your OHA. So you can get online and take that survey between now and 31 May. On the 22nd of May, we're going to have our semi-annual summer safety stand down. That'll be from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. at Fleet Theater. Good chance to come out and get some ideas on how to have a safe summer. I mean, it's getting warmer out. People are doing more things outside. You got to be careful about heat exhaustion and heat stress and not getting the minor injuries like I usually do on the softball field. If you live in Goban, Rokuban, or Hachiban Towers, the good news is you're getting new ACs installed. The potentially not so good news is they may not be up and ready until sometime in June. So there's a potential that we'll be turning the ACs on and yours won't be ready to be turned on yet. The contractor is working it hard. We hope to have those done in time for when it gets really hot and humid out. One note, due to the big energy conservation push we have to have and the $2.6 million we got to cut out of our utility budget, the ACs will probably get turned on a little later this year than they did last year. One of those reasons is the new criteria is last year it was 78 degrees, at least 78 degrees for 3 days in a row before you turn the ACs on. This year it's been mandated that it's 80 degrees for 3 days in a row before we can turn the ACs on. So it's probably going to be a little later this year than it was last year. And in the first month of what we're being monitored on for our energy conservation, the month of March, we missed the mark, CFAY. We did not make our goal for energy conservation on the first month of statistics. I don't have the numbers for April yet. I think we did okay for April, but be smart out there. You know, turn lights off when you're not in the rooms using them, and just don't be wasteful with your energy so we can make our goal to match what's been cut from the budget. Some NWR events coming up. Right now, summer camp registration is going on. You can be obtaining your lottery number so you can from the Yokosuka Youth Admin Office, so you can get your kids in some programs and registration this summer. 2 May through 5 May, Cinco de Mayo. There's going to be lots of stuff at the different clubs here. You can go online, check the options, or you can call 241-2209 if you want to find out what's happening Cinco de Mayo-wise. We have some Captain's Cup events coming up. This Saturday, 4 May, is the Captain's Cup Men's Co-Rec Flag Football Tournament. So it's four men and four women comprise a team. And then on 6 May, Captain's Cup Men's and Women's Flag Football starts. That's a 7-on-7 event. One more Captain's Cup event, Men's and Women's Racquetball. That'll start on the 13th of May. That's a tournament. Oh, one day you don't want to forget. Believe me, you don't want to forget this day coming up. 12 May is Mother's Day, all right? So if you haven't sent your cards or thought about getting flowers ordered or something, now's a good time to do that. The clubs will probably have meals. Reservations are highly recommended for Mother's Day. Please, don't make your mother cook on Mother's Day. I mean, come on, that's not fair. Mothers shouldn't have to be cooking on Mother's Day. There is going to be a Mother's Day run on 11 May on the Ikego track. That's going to be either a 2K or a 4K run walk, whichever one you sign up for, and that's at 10 o'clock on the 11th of May. One of my favorite topics I'm going to bring up right now is the Bay Stars. The Yokosuka Bay Stars have some home games coming up. But one of significance, on the 7th of May, that is Tuesday, game starts at 6 p.m. But at 5:30, our very own Kinnick Red Devils baseball team is going to get to go out on the field and have the pros hit them some balls. So if you got the time available, come on out to Apama on the 7th and watch the Kinnick Red Devils in uniform out on the field. Showing off their stuff. I mean, that's a really cool deal we were able to arrange, and I think that'd be awesome. And then the Bay Stars play their game at 6, and you can watch them that night. And they play the following night also at 6, and they got a couple of day games here on Friday and Monday thanks to Golden Week. So if you can play hooky and get out to the ball field, you can do that on Friday or Monday. The schedule, I think they play at 12 on Friday, and I think they play at 1300 on Monday, something like that. But again, the Kinnick Red Devils are going to be out there at Apama Stadium. It's going to be a great treat for the kids, and come on out and support them. All right, on to the trivia. Well, picking the trivia questions were easy this time because I got no answers to the ones I tried last time, so we're just going to do a repeat here. The song I was looking for, here's the lyrics. Give me the TV show this song goes to. All these nights when you got no lights, the check is in the mail, and your little angel hung the cat up by its tail. All right, so give me the TV show that one goes to. Also, this game, this kid's game, was the precursor to Transformers. Can you name it? I had one when I was a kid. I thought it was pretty cool. I played with it a lot. But the precursor to Transformers, and I had no idea that it was going to become Transformers eventually. And then finally, I see a lot of people out on the track doing their PRTs. I saw a group out there this morning when I was jogging by. Hopefully with the new surface, they're shaving some seconds off their time. But that leads me to the question, what is the world record for the mile for both men and women? Not that anybody here from CFAY is going to break that during the PRT, but I was just wondering. It's just a good question. What is the mile record? Seeing everybody's going to be talking about how fast they were in the mile and a half here. All right, CFAY, that's all I have for today. As usual, good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. And good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. Have a great week, CFAY, and be safe this weekend.